is shipping day. Got a whole bunch of orders. So thanks to everyone who supported the whatnot last night. We had a total of 74 units go out the door. That includes 4 giveaways. So 70 items sold last night. Really great show. I had a lot of fun. The inventory was awesome. So I appreciate everybody supporting that and coming in and hanging out. Whether you bought something or bought 7 things or just hung out, tapped the screen, sent me some positive vibes, I appreciate it. Boy, we had some cool stuff up on the screen last night. I think that was just a fun like show to watch. There was a lot of really, really cool stuff, some cool vintage stuff, some unique one-of-a-kind items, just some good stuff. Tej was there. Appreciate you, Tej. Already got your order out, shipped that out last night. So this morning we have a grand total of 42 packages for whatnot. Sorry, in total today, 42 packages for whatnot, 2 eBay orders. Both of the eBay orders are $50 orders, by the way. Good stuff. I have a TikTok shop order, and I think that's it. And who knows? Maybe we'll get some more TikTok shop orders and maybe a chris@peak.com order. Thank you so much for the corns. Good morning, everybody. South Texas is in the house. Thank you. Thank you. So, but I did ship 35 of those 42 whatnot orders last night. I was on a roll. Listening to some hip hop. We were live on TikTok. It was good, clean fun. If you're in the show, if you're in the live right now and you ordered something on whatnot last night, let me know and we'll get it shipped out right now with a big dose of gratitude, handwritten thank you card. You know the drill. If you're joining for the first time, what I do is I buy stuff for cheap at thrift stores, garage sales, estate sales, even retail stores in their clearance section. Did I mention garage sales? In garage sales. And I flip that stuff online on eBay, Poshmark, and whatnot. I also have my own coffee business. So I have a medium roast and a light roast. They're both roasted locally here in Black Mountain, North Carolina at Dynamite Roasting Company. Dynamite Roasting has won Western North Carolina's best coffee roaster 11 years in a row. That doesn't even make any sense. They're freaking awesome. The coffee is delicious. If you have questions about coffee, let me know. Whether it's about my coffee or just coffee in general, I like talking about coffee, so let me know. We're going to get some water shipped out. Biggie is here with the corns. Appreciate it. You lived in Boone, now Asheville. Do you fly fish? I don't. I fly fished once. I lived in Boone, then Asheville, then Denver, then Tampa, now back to Asheville. And we haven't visited Boone since we've been back. We've been back for a whole year now. Our one-year anniversary back in back here in Asheville in Western North Carolina in WNC was just a couple days ago. Kind of crazy. Nick Smith drinking the Peak Blend right now. If you're drinking Peak Blend right now, either the light roast, the Peak Blend, the OG, or if you're drinking Peak Season, which is this fall seasonal light roast, let me know down below. Put a coffee emoji down below. Most of all, good morning. Appreciate you sharing some time with me. Yeah, my most of my coffee I got from you. Appreciate that, Floor. Give me a coffee emoji if you're drinking some Chris at Peak coffee right now. I sure am. I got a nice coffee right now. All right, let's start. What do we got to do? We got to do whatnot orders. We got to do eBay orders, or we got to do a TikTok shop order. First person who says eBay Poshmark, or sorry, eBay whatnot. I don't have any Poshmark orders. eBay whatnot or TikTok shop. First person to say it down below, that's what we'll start. I got the medium roast. Nice, Floor. Appreciate you. Thank you, Paige. Thank you, Floor. What not first? Mine is brewing. Let's go, Cora. Cora's about to get a shot of energy. All right, so we're doing what's not first. Nick Smith is here. We'll get his order out. I don't think I did your order yet. I think I intentionally saved you for today, Nick Smith. Let me see if I can find you. The new shipping screen. I think I like it. I'm just still getting used to it on whatnot. I already ship it. Here it is. Global Vintage, Nick Smith. Thank you, brother. You get one of the marquee items of the night. So this vintage Tory Richard. Whew, what a piece this is. Y'all ready for this? Holy moly. Super one of a kind. That's the, what is that? The Mediterranean in the background. Some race cars. Oh my gosh. Vintage single stitch. All the things. Thank you, Nick Smith. If I have to part with a piece like this, I'm at least happy that it's going to my friend, Nick Smith. Thanks for your support, brother. Mon is brewing. What are your main products you sell besides coffee? I sell new and used clothing on eBay and Poshmark. I've been doing that for 5 years. December, which is only 2 months away, will mark 3 years of me being full-time since the last time I had a jobby job. And I go on TikTok. We're live right now on TikTok, on Facebook, and on YouTube. And just showing people my business, how I do it, what I do. And creating content about reselling for over 3 years now. Started in June of 2020, right in the middle of that little pandemic thing. 12.5% unemployment in June of 2020. Even more people were underemployed. And here I was. I had a good job. I worked from home. And I had a side hustle that was making me good money. I said, I have a responsibility to share this. So I got well over 1,000 videos posted here on TikTok and Instagram, and also more recently on Facebook and YouTube about this business. And I started the coffee business in April. And I love the coffee business. It's so much fun. I love talking coffee. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Tracy. The beauty of being your own boss, potluck without asking permission for time off. Well, potluck's like after hours, right? The potluck's at, I don't know what time it is, 6, 7, something like that tonight. But yeah, your point remains that yes, no permission for nothing. All right, Nick, we'll get your order out, brother. Appreciate you. One of the big hits of the night, this Tory Richard vintage piece. Handwritten thank you card for you, Nick. Thank you for the follow, Lisa. Did I already say that? Howdy, partner. Kimbo's in the house over on YouTube. What's up? Some of our regulars haven't popped in yet over on Facebook and YouTube. Yeah. Kimo, where's the gang? Gang, I blame Chemo. I'm just happy everyone who is here. This is going out to Nick Smith. We'll get this shipped right out. Going to Casa Grande. It's going out Wednesday. I think you'll get this on Monday, bud. The thing about I love about the reselling business, it's one of those things that it's a great side hustle. You can start this business with almost no money. Basically, you got $125 you can scrap together. You're good. That'll get you your first trip to the thrift store will get you some inventory. It'll get you some shipping materials like these 9x12 poly bags. You know, you probably should get a scale if you're just first getting started. They're like $25 or $30. If you don't have some way to print labels at home, it's probably a good idea to get a label printer or something. But you can get all that stuff for about $125-ish, $150. You start up your own business, do it out of your house, and then you can use the profits from your business to scale and whatever. And then eventually use that business to grow into something different, like for me, is coffee, which is really fun. So I think it's a great starter business. It's a great way to kind of learn the responsibility of running your own show. How do you batch your whatnot orders? 43 orders, that's a lot for a home packing business. I don't know. I don't know if I really batch them, Opal. I just run through the list and ship them all out. It's 42 orders, by the way. Yeah, it's a lot of orders, but you just jam them out. It is what it is. Y'all know I liked the shipping. Mother Nature Show's here. We were just talking about you. You had to go shopping. That's all right, Mother Nature Show. Hope you're doing well. Thanks for joining, as always. Good to have you. My friend from London. Can you mention your TikTok in your description? Can you mention your TikTok in your descriptions and your eBay listings? Or do you? I don't. I suppose you could. I don't see any reason why you couldn't. I don't know that there would be a ton of benefit to it, but I'm not sure. People could check me out if they wanted to. It's the same name, Chris at Pete. Nick Smith started with $325 and paid himself back in 6 weeks. Smart guy, that Nick Smith. The cleanest office that you'll ever see in reselling. Me too, it's always his fault. Oh yeah, I get you. It is Chemo's fault. That fella. Appreciate y'all being here. All right, Nick Smith, you got a shipping confirmation. Hold on, wait for it. In your inbox. Thank you, Nick Smith. Appreciate you. All right, our next order is going out to, what's about my mom's order? My mom got 5 items. My dad's gonna be pissed. Sorry, Dad. Dad might be watching this morning. If you're watching, Dad, say hello. And if you don't know how to use the YouTube thing to say hello, you can just text me and say hello. Let me know if you're watching. You can just use the SMS if you want to. This order is going out to Mom Peak. All right, we got an Orbis shirt. Dad, I'm sorry that we got Mom on Whatnot. Where did I put that shirt? Oh, here it is. I'm sorry, Dad. It's not my fault. She bought a lot of mediums. Large, medium, 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 XL. Well, the mediums fit my dad. I don't know who the large and the extra large is for. I like that you're keeping tabs on Mom. She's got a lot of mediums. Just got 2 going out today. No worry. I got 2 eBay orders myself going out, but they're both $50 eBay orders. You want to check those out. So Mom Peep got this Orbis. This is in the Buy It Now. I thrifted this yesterday. It's got like a ruffled front and a gingham pattern. It's actually a really cool Orbis shirt. I threw everything that I found at the thrift store in the live thrift yesterday. I just put it in the Buy It Now section for $12 a pop. Give some people some deals. You can't get sniped on those. So Mom got that Orbis. Mom got brand new with tags on Tuckett, size medium, slim fit. I don't know, Mom, if Dad is medium, slim fit. There's a wrinkle-free little piece here. I don't know if Dad's slim fit. I'm just saying. Sorry, Dad. Is there a way to disconnect a credit card from Whatnot? So cool to have my parents supporting me. They always have with my business or whatever the heck I've been doing. They always support me. Whatever crazy ideas I have, sometimes they'll be like, that's kind of a crazy idea. Are you sure? I'm like, yep. They're like, cool. You know that you can be successful. So nice little Untuckit piece. There we go. Would you recommend the wireless Bluetooth ID PRT or the wireless one? I think the wireless one only works with PC. So I think that's worth noting, but I've never used the wireless one, so I can't speak to that. I think it would be nice having a wireless printer, but then again, my printer sits in the same place every day, so whether it's wired or not wired isn't really like a big deal for me. Got a Wrangler Pearl Snap. This is the medium. I really like this Wrangler. I like these Wranglers that got these like little like details. See the stitching there? That unique stitching. All the way around, all the pockets, all the way down, even on the back. Nice piece. This is in crispy good condition too. That's awesome, Mama Peak Shops, your Whatnot. Yeah, I mean, it's awesome. I think my dad probably doesn't think it's awesome. Mom likes to shop. She's not here to defend herself, but we'll just say that. Mom likes to shop. It's a start. There you go. Mom likes to shop. And if she was here, I'd be saying the same things. I don't know if Dad's watching this morning. No, I didn't get a text from him. I don't think he's watching. Sorry, Dad. This is a sweet shirt, though. I've never seen my dad wear a Western shirt in my entire life. Now he's got one. Nice little Wrangler piece there. All right, what else we got going out for Mom? Patagonia men's medium. This might be a little snug for Dad too, Mom. Patagonia's run a little on the smaller side. Nice little organic cotton, polyester, lightweight. Nice little Florida piece right there. Patagonia. Got this Link sole. This is a nice piece. Link sole. Got two Link soles going out the door today. One on eBay also. Boom. It's a size XL Link sole. I don't know what you're going to do with this shirt, Mom. Plug it into the laptop. That's awesome. Mama Peek Shops, you whatnot. I have to plug it in. Dub's getting a new wardrobe. Yeah, Dad does not need a new wardrobe. Sorry, Dad. This might be too much information, but it is what it is. My dad has like a whole freaking closet full of shirts. He could not wear the same shirt. Like, he could probably go 40 days without doing laundry and wear a new shirt every single day. A new short sleeve, lightweight Florida shirt. But it's good to see him getting some stuff that's beyond Real Legends. He likes those Real Legend shirts. But we got him some non-Real Legends. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That Orvis is a women's shirt. So we've got 4 shirts coming this way. And we're going to ship these out. This and let's do this. Gosh, I really wish I could have the music playing. I like having music and whatnot. Wish we had some thrift shops out there. Yeah, what do you call them? Charity shops or something out there? Hardly any staff in the shop. It's all service staff. It's just, oh, it's all self-service. Interesting. Very interesting. Variety is the spice of life. There you go. Trisha Smith is in the building. What's up, Trisha? What's up, Trisha? Nobody, I'd love to hear from y'all. What's going on for sales? What are you shipping out this morning? What is going on? This is a thank you card going out right there. Mom, thank you. Dad, sorry. Sorry about contributing to the credit card bill, Dad. All right, these are all gonna go in a box. Let's see. 55 ounces we have to work with. We're gonna use a shoebox. So we still got a few more whatnot orders. They're all big orders that we're doing now. Starting a reselling business or growing a reselling business is a great place to ask. If I don't have an answer, there's a bunch of smart resellers in the shop. Also, whatever question that you're thinking about asking, but you're not sure if you should ask that question, there's probably 7 other people who are doing the same thing. They want to ask that same question, but they're not sure if they should. They think it's a dumb question, but there's a lot of people who have that same question, I guarantee you. So ask away. I love talking reselling. I think you can have royalty-free music. Yeah, I don't even want to mess with it because if Facebook tends to be really, really finicky with their AI about music. And if they pull your stuff down, it can be a real pain in the butt to get your account back in good standing. I just don't want to mess with it. Facebook is really, really finicky. And it is really hard to get a hold of anybody and get anything fixed. You know, because they're a super big, really rich company and they can't afford to put together good customer service. You probably already know how I feel about that. What's your incoming and outgoing inventory goal for a week? That's a tough question to answer.
Probably, a hundred. It's tricky because my business is a little bit different and it's been changing over the past several months. So now that I have coffee, now that I've added whatnot, we'll just go with 100 and 100. I like that. Coffee is delicious. That's the peak blend. That's the medium roast. Iced with just a little bit of oat milk. Delicious. Do you refund shipping for a doesn't fit return when detailed measurements were in the listing? I do not. But I do free returns on everything. So I wouldn't refund their initial. The buyer pays the $5.95 initial shipping. I don't refund that ever unless I made a mistake. But I always pay return shipping. Take us on, not me. Be better. And it won't take a nap. You're going to make have a heart to heart with eBay today. Sorry that you have to contact eBay. It sounds like zero fun. Talking to eBay is zero fun. Disaster here in Florida. Ran out of peak blend. Just ordered more. Hunter, do you just order more right now? Where'd you order? TikTok shop or chris@peak.com? Let me know. We'll get you shipped right out. I can look myself. I got eyes. Where I had TikTok shop open. Your website. Okay, cool. I got you. I got you right now. Thank you, Hunter. We'll get you out right quick. Are you 100% out? Can't let that happen. Peak has got you. Just like if Bezos knew you were out of coffee, he would just jump right to action. Somebody wake up Bezos. He's taking an afternoon nap on his yacht in the Mediterranean. Wake him up. Hunter needs coffee. We got three bags. Does that sound right? Three bags of the regular grind of the medium roast, right? One, two, three. Thank you so much, Hunter. Pickles loves your coffee over here. Pickles loves your coffee. Who's Pickles? Sounds like a, I hope that's a dog's nickname. Tell me that's not a human's nickname. Thank you, Hunter. Going down to St. Pete with three bags of peak blend. We'll get you shipped out right now. What are we going to do with a package for this? We're going to put it in here. Can we fit three in this? I think we've done three in this. Yeah, we can put three in there. Let's go. First, let me see what that rate is going to be first before I get all crazy. Before I get all crazy, Hunter has got an order. Thank you, Hunter. Pickles? That's freaking rude. Are you serious? Lola. You call the kid Pickles? Does he like this nickname? Shipping out Halloween yard decoration, Bonobos golf polo, and full zip Packers hoodie. Not bad. I like it, Tracy. Got peak blend order weeks ago. Brought in from mailbox, can't find it. Any idea where I put it? That is an awesome question. But that's also terrible. You can't find your coffee. You should be able to smell it with your nose. You have like a hunting dog or something. Train the scent. Are you serious? You can't find it? Well, that's kind of funny. I mean, it's not funny, but it's funny. Let's try it tragic.
Hunter, thanks so much for your support. Hunter, are you coming back to WNC next year for the summer? I think that's an every year thing you said. Hunter, do you want me to include a bag of the, do you want to do one bag of light roast and mix that in, the fall seasonal light roast? It's up to you. I don't know if you've tried it yet. Let me know. It's got tasting notes of crisp apple, orange peel, and a little bit of caramel. Let me know, Hunter. I can throw one of those bags in, so you can do two mediums and one light. And you can blend them too. So you can, like, when you're doing your coffee, you can put like 50-50 or two-thirds medium, one-third of the other. Let me know. If I don't hear back from you, I'll just ship out those three. Yep, Sirius is Sunday. Does he like that name? I pet in a way, but not. La Ciotat, France is the West Mediterranean. He is still moored there. Thank you for checking up on our friend Bezos. This is a new light roast, or the same one I already have from a couple weeks ago. I think you got the fall. It's been fall for, it'll, tomorrow will make it a full 4 weeks since we flipped to fall. So I think you have the fall. It was right around the time we made the switch when you made your order. Hunter, I didn't hear back from you, so I'm going to roll with the order that you asked for. You should, for some reason. I do. Is this a new list? Doesn't matter if he likes it. He likes me. I let a live name him. Oh my gosh. Like, what's the live pickles? Of all things you could name this poor kid. I like giving people nicknames, and I don't think they have a say. But pickles, that sucks. In that kid's defense, I don't know if he deserves defense, but I don't know the kid. But Songgun, that's a bad name. I think you can have a rotate. Chris, did you find out how many cups are in a bag? I didn't. Why I ask is some coffee sellers here ask how many cups do you drink a day, then sign you up for a coffee subscription, and their orders are just sent out. I don't know. The thing of it is, people drink their coffee different ways too. So I can measure the cups that I do it, but you might not use the same amount. But I could guess I could use an average amount. I brew my coffee differently. I do a French press, so I don't know if mine will be the same. I have to like Google something and see. I'm sure you can just Google this whole thing. Mother Nature showing me. Google how many cups is a 12 ounce coffee. 12 ounces of coffee, how many cups? Thank you so much, Hunter. That's going out today, Wednesday. It's going priority. You're going to have that Friday down there in St. Pete. Sorry you ran out of coffee. We're rushing that out to you. 2-day delivery on that. Different size spoons, etc. I see. Yeah, different people like it stronger, weaker. Okay, leave it to me. Google it up. You can do this. Thanks, Hunter. Appreciate you. As always, if you get an order in at chris@peak.com or on TikTok shop, I'll stop what I'm doing. We'll get it shipped right out, just like Hunter, with a big dose of gratitude. Thanks for supporting my tiny little business over here. You know I love the coffee, and I know Hunter loves the coffee too. Appreciate that. All right, so let's get back to Whatnot. We got another Whatnot order. Thanks everyone who came out last night. Oops, I got hit. Gonna make sure Mom gets her shipping confirmation. Mom, you got a shipping confirmation in your inbox. We got an order here from Roots. Thank you so much, Roots. Thanks for your generosity. Love these demonstrations of generosity. So good for our community, for everyone just to be supporting everyone. A lot of generosity last night. People were buying, like, they were going into the buy it now section and gifting stuff to other people. So last night, Bold North gifted one of these Thrifting is My Cardio haul bags. We're getting low on these. And he gifted one to Ruth. And then that was his one purchase for the night. And he won the big giveaway, the brand new in box ultra running shoes in his size. So that worked out nice too. So we dropped $20 and won $140 pair of running shoes just out of that. But it's all about the generosity.
you give, the world just gives you back. Sometimes it's not that immediate, but all right, the viewer's choice number three. So the Roots got this Pendleton. There was a lot of generosity last night from Roots. I'm trying to see. We didn't run the Pendleton twice, did we? That was just once. Okay. Yeah, okay. So check out this Pendleton. This is the viewer's choice. You had the choice of this Pendleton. I didn't tell you what the choice is. I just said buttons or snaps. So you ended up being either this Pendleton with the buttons or this Dixon flannel with the snaps. So this Dixon flannel will make another appearance at some point. Really cool pieces. Pendleton out the door to the Roots. Thank you so much. Good karma. Both gorgeous. Thank you, Willow. What did you think about the shirts?
I appreciate the compliment, though.
Wow, that's nice.
Yes, that just feels good.
That just feels good. Thank you, Willow. What a sweetie.
What did you think of the shirts?
Good karma. Call them all whatever. 32.4 cups in a 12-ounce bag, so about 42 cents for a cup.
There you go. Way cheaper than going to the coffee shop. But if you are going to go to a coffee shop, support a local coffee shop.
Or do whatever you want. But you know my opinion on the whole thing. Support local. Support small businesses. If you don't, all we'd be left with is these big corporate places. We don't care about you. All right, we got a Pendleton. Where is my shipping screen? Why are you up? Very strange. All right, Pendleton. We got a cool fleece, nice piece right here. One of my favorite brands. You know I love my cool. We got some holiday Toms going out the door. These are super fun. My local coffee shop in 1987 at the University of Washington with Starbucks. There you go. Did they over roast their coffee back then too, or is that just more of a modern thing since they've gone corporate? Burned. Were all their coffees blended back then, or did they actually have single origin, single source fair trade coffee, or was it always just over roasted beans bought at commodity pricing? I need to know. It was dark and bitter then as well. You may have just answered my question. The coffee game's a little different nowadays. And just like a lot of like food and stuff like that. More about the organic, fair trade, fresh stuff, farm, you know, right from the farm, farm to table. You are such a good person. Supernova, thank you so much. Okay, I swiped off and back. What did I miss the 5 seconds I was gone? You missed everything. I like both. Oh, thanks, Lola. Good morning, Mama Havoc. Appreciate you being here as always. My husband always says Starbucks tastes burnt. There's a reason for that. There's a strategy of why they do what they do. And it's worked for them, and I'm proud of them. They're running a great business. They take good care of their employees, by the way, too. I can't give them too much of a hard time. All right, we got these Toms. Check out these holiday Toms, Halloween Toms. Pretty cool, right? Brand new with tags. Going out the door to the Roots. To the Roots. Peace of mind, drinking tea, coffee. Appreciate that. Because you're supporting my small little business, you're supporting Dynamite's small business, and you're supporting small farmers. sort of reuse this little padded bag here that somebody shipped to me. This is a return. We're going to throw that all in a box. Let's see. Does anyone know? Do these cost money? These ready post things that you get from the post office when somebody has a return shipping label? Do you have to pay for these at the post office when somebody returns something from eBay? Looks like they just picked this up like in line there at the post office. I'm assuming they have to buy that bag, right? Thank you, Roots. Appreciate your support. Good stuff. So we got, well, the Roots also bought this vintage nutmeg shirt twice. They bought it, they asked me to rerun it. They bought it again, and they asked me to give it away. We're gonna give it away next week. I'll show you that shirt in just a second. So we got 1, 2, 3. Yep. Okay. We got that order all ready. Generate label. Thank you, Roots. Appreciate it. Got you a nice little box of goodies. You got you some good stuff coming. Those Toms, that Pendleton, and that cool quarter zip fleece. Really nice piece. Excited to give away that nutmeg piece, which I'll show off in a second. Excited to give that away next week. Thanks so much for giving so much to me and so much to the community at the same time. Everybody wins. I love it. We're going to do some giveaways actually today. Let's do that. Do some giveaways. I meant to do some yesterday and I forgot. Casey, thank you. Nice little box of goodies. And this is the shirt that the Roots bought twice. This piece here, vintage nutmeg, made in the USA, 1993, Dallas Cowboys, Troy Aikman, Emmett Smith, embroidered up here. True made in the USA, single stitch vintage. This is what the shirt, people always think starter, but this is really what people are looking for, is this nutmeg. These shirts are freaking awesome, really sought after. People collect them. And this is in crispy, crisp condition. We're gonna give this away courtesy of the Roots on next week's show. Don't miss next week's show. It's going to be loaded up just like last night's show with very similar stuff. 10 Lululemons, Patagonia, Robert Graham, Pendleton. I think I got some Lilly Pulitzer. Territory Ahead, Rock Revival. What'd I miss? Cool. All the stuff. Good stuff. Packed house. Thank you. Thank you. We are so excited. Going to the post office. You're going to have some. That Pendleton shirt's really awesome. Thank you, Roots. Two things about Peak Club, no SB. Two things about no SB or DD, also no, as he must be named Starbucks. Listen, you drink whatever you need to drink to wake you up in the morning. But if you can make it happen where you can buy fair trade, organic, roasted fresh every Thursday and support a small business, I would appreciate it. But you drink whatever you got to drink. It's probably like $3 at the post office. Oh my gosh. Yes, those do cost money. Good morning, Sheila. Sorry, I missed your walk-in. My son manages an SB in downtown Chicago. That's awesome. I hear they take good care of their employees. Although for some reason, a lot of their employees, I think they're dealing with like a some sort of weird lawsuit or something, even though they do really nice things for their employees, like paying like tuition reimbursement and stuff for people who are part-time. Like they do a lot of cool stuff. But I know where you can get better coffee. Cool shirt for sure. Yes, absolutely. Going to the post office, 6 sales yesterday. Let's go, Christina. Q4 is here. Wishing everybody a nice upturn in sales. If you want more sales, give it some more hustle. You get out what you put back in. Roots, you got a shipping confirmation in your inbox. Thank you so much. And we'll give away that nutmeg vintage shirt next week. That'll be good, clean, fun. We got a package going out to my friend Karen K. Roth. Let's get your handwritten thank you note. What do we got, Karen? Karen's got Rock Revivals and Lululemon. That's a nice package, eh? Lululemon Rock Revival. It's a good time to point out, too, that I've started offering consignment, and these are number 28 and number 9. 28. I've started offering consignment. So if you want to see your pieces featured on a Whatnot show, what I'll do is after this Whatnot show, I'm going to pay out my consignees. I had 3 people consign items in last night's show. I'm going to pay them out today, right after I finish all my shipping. I update the spreadsheet with all their inventory. I update all the sales so they can see the fees and all that. And I send them a payment on PayPal or Venmo today. So you ship out your items to me. I get them. I put them in an upcoming show. They sell fast. Everything sells that goes in the show because everything starts at $1. And then you get paid out. The splits are crazy. They're the best consignment splits I've ever offered. And I've been doing consignment for a long time. I've never offered splits better than 60-40. And even when I offered 60-40, that was only on items that were $125 sale price or more. I'm offering 70-30 splits. That's after Whatnot takes their fees. By far, the best splits that I've ever offered on consignment. Got a lot of experience doing consignment. I'll take really good care of you. It's gonna be really organized. You're gonna get a shared spreadsheet as soon as I get your stuff. And they get fast payouts. So if you got a death pile, I don't want all of it. I want the best stuff in your death pile, stuff that sells for $25 or more, the good stuff, and we'll sell it quick. If you want to know more about consignment on my Whatnots, you can go to whatnot.chrisatpeak.com or consignment.chrisatpeak.com. You can find out everything you need to know. Whatnot.chrisatpeak.com. Thank you so much, Karen, for your support. Nice pair of Rock Revivals going out the door. $70-$30 splits is crazy. Nobody's doing that. Try going down to your local consignment shop and say, hey, I know this guy who's doing $70-$30 splits. Will you do that? And will you pay me out immediately when an item sells? And will everything sell this week? Ask them those 3 questions. See what they say to you. They'll probably kick you out of the freaking store. Be nice to them, but they ain't going to give you 70-30 splits. Has anybody ever sold at a consignment shop locally? What's up, Ruth? Good morning, Flipping by Tanya. But I bid on the wrong jeans. Oh, no. You bid on the wrong jeans? Which ones did you mean to bid on? Do you want to cancel these ones? Oh, I sent you the wrong jeans. I have a Mountain Hardware smooth as a rabbit's back fleece in my pile. I want that. The flares, gotcha. That was the polo Ralph Lauren. Shoot. Were they both the same size? Size 29? All good, okay. You sure? Just want y'all to be happy. Guess great benefits at SB. He's happy, makes this mama happy. That's good. Good, honest work there. Running a Starbucks. That's big business too. If he can run himself a Starbucks, with all the business that's coming through there, you can run himself a lot of different businesses. That was my intro to business, was restaurants, similar to coffee shops. You can run a restaurant. You can run a lot of stuff. Or a coffee shop, for that matter. Thank you, Karen. Put your handwritten thank you card in. Thank you. This is going to be inside 39 ounces. Oh, yeah, we're good. Thank you, Karen. Plus, reduce the shipping for the Lululemon shorts for my daughter. You got a nice price on the Lululemon shorts, too. You cannot argue. I think it was $15 for Lulu shorts. And you know, because they said excellent use condition down below, you know that these have been carefully looked over. All my items are blasted underneath the photo lights. There's good reason why I take photos of all those items. I want you to be able to see what you're getting. But also, it gives me an opportunity to look those things over really carefully. So like, find and disclose even like the tiniest little blemishes. I'll tell you all about them. I need help with something, pretty please. Let me know, Debbie. We're here. You got a whole bunch of people listening. If those jeans were bigger, I would have bought them. Really nice. Thank you. Hey, good morning, Caroline. Yes, consignment shop paid well before COVID. Now I get like 10%. Yep. Go ask them. Go be like, hey, what about that dude, Chris at Peak? He gives 70%. Could you match that? Could you even get close to it? See what they say. 70% splits. If you're interested in consignment, go to consignment.chrisatpeak.com. Other people's stuff I sell 50-50. Yep. I used to do, and I still do, I do a tiered split for eBay. So anything that sells for under $50 goes for a 40-60 split. So the client gets 40% if it's under $50. If it's between 50 and 125, we split it 50-50. If it's over 125, we split it 60-40, meaning I give them 60. And if it sells for under $20, then for me, I'm going to buy them out at, you know, $1 or $2. Most things that are going to go under $20, I'm not even going to take. But say there's something that I do take that's close to $20, I'm going to pay them out $1 or $2 on those pieces. And I don't take flawed items. But that's for eBay and stuff. For whatnot, 70-30 split. The client gets 70%. I just take a measly 30. And I take all the photos. I build out that spreadsheet. I pay you the next day. I put on the production. By the way, I do the giveaways. I pay the money for high-end giveaways that get people in the show, keep people in the show. I pay for all those. You don't have to worry about it. You don't have to promote the show. I do all that stuff on all the social media platforms. Let me do all the work. You take 70%. I take 30%. I got some people who are sending me stuff, boxes every week, because they're like, you know what? I could list all this stuff and spend all that time listing it, or I could just make a little bit less money because we're splitting at 70-30. I can take a little bit less money, but boy, I have like no work. I just source the stuff. I throw it in a box. I take some quick pictures of it just to show Peak what he's getting, and I ship it out, and he sends me money a week later. It's that simple. So it's another source of income. I got some people who are like hard goods resellers who send me all their clothing that they find because they're like, I don't like listing clothing. I want to focus on the hard goods anyway. So, but I got an eye for clothing and I find good stuff. I'm going to send it to Peak. consignment.chrisatpeak.com. If you want to check it out, I got a link in the profiles too. 70-30 is crazy. I don't know how long I can offer 70-30, but I'm doing it right now. They order two things on eBay. Please walk me through it. I need help with something. How do I combine shipping? Kind of tricky, Debbie. Okay. eBay is so unnecessarily hard to do. So what you're going to do, you have to get to the bulk shipping screen. So how does one get to the bulk shipping screen? I have all this stuff bookmarked so I don't have to find it every freaking time. Wonder if I can just Google this eBay bulk shipping, if it will just bring me to it. Guide to bulk shipping labels. How do I print labels in bulk? How do I print USPS in bulk? You can access the bulk shipping tool directly by visiting. Okay. Let's see if this link works. Yep. Okay. I'm going to give you a link. And from here, it should be pretty easy. Copy. And then see if it'll let me paste here. eBay is sometimes, this is one of those things that eBay is just like unnecessarily complicated at, unfortunately. Let's see. I just want to like send you a message in the chat. How the heck do I do that? Speaking of unnecessarily complicated, what button do I hit to send a freaking message on here? Tried every button. What is this one? No. I can't do it. So what it's going to be, it's ebay.com/bulk.labels. ebay.com/bulk.labels. Go to that website. Sorry, it won't let me enter anything into the chat on here. Can I trust you, Chris? It's a win-win for all. I'd say if you can trust Chris with your life. Careful. I don't want that much responsibility. I'm just starting and I have a few questions. Yeah, let me know. So did you try going to that, Debbie? Just let me know. ebay.com/bulk.labels. Go to that. That should be able to, you should be able to see how to combine from there. Let me know. Thank you for the heart me. Mike Lorenzo is in the house with his Boston accent. Back to whatnot, back to whatnot. Let me know your progress over there. Debbie, let me know your progress. We'll take care of you. I'm going to keep shipping, but I want to help you here too. Karen, you got a shipping confirmation in your inbox. Those are going priority. It's Wednesday. It's going to Illinois. You're going to get those on Friday. Pretty good. All right, we get an order from my friend Dwight. Dwight, are you hanging out? Are you working in the background today? Dwight, are you out there? We got a Robert Graham, a Beta brand, and a Wrangler. I like this Wrangler a lot. I like this Robert Graham a lot. And I like Beta brand. This is a good box. Robert Graham. Check out this Robert Graham. Sicky, sick, sick. Sicky, sick, sick Robert Graham. Embroidered flowers and stuff. Oh, gosh, is that crazy. Seven. I love the embroidery on that shirt. Crazy. Bought a Sean John blazer for $6.99. What should I charge for shipping? For blazers, I typically charge $10.99 for shipping. For some people, that'll be, if it goes to California, it might be a little bit more. But if it goes, for me, like if it goes locally, it'll be a lot less. So some items I make of, you know, a buck or two on shipping. Other items I lose a buck or two on shipping. But I charge $10.99 for all blazers. Suits, I charge $12.99. No. Yeah? I'm going to listen to suit a little bit. Might be $13.99 is what I charge for suits. I don't know. I just do sell similar on all my items, so it's already, that shipping price is already in there. Dwight, this freaking shirt is fire, brother. Beautiful shirt. Hey, Chris, what type of clothing for the whatnot deal? Very specific on any clothing. D-Ra, great question. You can check out all those details, consignment.chris@peak.com. You can see exactly how the whole process works. There's a big list of brands that I'm looking for. It's not an exhaustive list. It's not every single brand, but it will give you an idea of what kind of stuff. It's throwing it up in era. He has a list on his website. Thank you for that, Trisha. I found my first Robert Graham, but upon further inspection, it was stained. I was bummed. That's a bummer. All right, so here's how I found that link. It should work for you too. I just searched for eBay bulk shipping and the third result was bulk shipping tool. So just search for that. eBay bulk shipping, third result, it says bulk shipping tool. Click it, and if you click on that, there'll be a link on that page you can go to. Sorry, it's not letting me like type anything into the chat. And eBay is unnecessarily complicated. It's not my fault, it's their fault. We'll get you through this though. I don't have a bulk order to do, so I can't like walk you through it. I don't have one. So therefore I can't do it. Robert Graham, Beta brand, and Wrangler. Throwing up an error. Thank you. Beautiful shirt. I love the embroidery. I bought a Sean John blazer. Just starting out. Here's that Wrangler. It's got the metallic stripes in it. Vintage piece. Really lightweight. Size 3X. I would list this piece on eBay for $23 plus shipping. If it was a smaller size, I'd probably list it for, well, I'd probably still list it for 23 with the metallic stripes. So it's little unique things like that that help items sell. It's
especially in a crowded market like Wrangler, which is a really crowded market on eBay and Poshmark. So all those like little things that make items unique really help items sell. All right, and we got to get this beta brand. I think I found it. Nice. From there, you should be able to figure out the bulk shipping. It'll give you some, there'll be, should be like a combined shipping thing. If you click the checkbox right next to the listings, it should get fairly intuitive from there. You just have to be able to find that screen. That's the tricky part. It's unnecessarily complicated. You would think that that would be like a really easy thing to do on eBay. I would bookmark that screen, by the way. Put that in one of your bookmarks so you don't have to go search for it every time you go through this. That's what I do. I bookmark all those things on eBay because they're so hard to find. It's a freaking maze of old technological infrastructure. What's going on, Travis George? There's a video on bulk shipping. There you go. If you have to create a video about it, it tells me that you probably made it too complicated on your platform. It should be super intuitive, shouldn't it? It should be the easiest thing in the world. You hanging out this morning, boy? Thanks, brother. Appreciate you. I didn't make a video. I just shared it. I didn't make a video. I just shared it. We are good. Debbie, you got that all figured out? I was trying to make some of the discount. I was trying to make some of the discount I gave her back. Nice. I like it.
Nice, nice. Good morning, Amanda Reads.
Her name is Amanda.
She can read.
It's Amanda Reads.
Pile of little packages over there. I don't know if you can see that on TikTok. That's just a portion of them. Dwight, you got a shipping confirmation in your inbox. That's going to priority, and it's just going to Tennessee. You're going to get that right quick, brother. Could be tomorrow. If not, it'll be Friday. All right, we got a order for Ashbergs. Ashbergs, you're hanging out this morning. Ashbergs, we got a Robert Graham, a nice, sensible Robert Graham. We got some coffee. What do we got? We got a peak season light roast. Ground peak season. There we go. Fall seasonal. Get it while you can. That's going to go away on December 1st. We'll rotate to the winter seasonal at that point. There's that Robert Graham. Nice, sensible Robert Graham, but it's still got a flip cuff, so you know that Ashberg likes to party. Thank you, Ashley. Trying a different shipping style today. Usually what I do is I take everything off the racks, off the hangers, I fold everything, and then I pile it all up and then I start fulfilling orders. Today I'm just pulling items off the rack, folding them to order. Folded to order shirts, how about it? Please don't forget to delay my package, Christopher. Yep, I got you set aside over there. Can I delay you just 2 days? The more I delay it, the more it hurts my shipping metrics. Is it okay if we just do 2 days? You let me know. What's best for the customer is best for me. But we can't wait too long. We got an Eddie Bauer going out the door. Was out of the buy it now section. I like these Eddie Bauer Travex shirt. Here's a women's Travex. You know it's Travex with that little yellow logo. They're typically like polyester, nylon, spandex blend shirts for hiking and stuff. More desirable Eddie Bauer. The best Eddie Bauer is the First Ascent stuff. That tends to be the most desirable and then fetch the best money. I do pick some Eddie Bauer. It's not the best resale brand, but if you know what to look for, you can make some money with Eddie Bauer. And Ashley's gotten herself a nice quality shirt. That's the thing. These things are, I mean, this is like a super high quality shirt. I have another question. Since I'm not a creator, would it really matter if I ordered spreadsheet now? Jason's spreadsheet? Just kind of depends on what you want to do. If you order it now, then you have a spreadsheet for this year. If you wait until his 2024 spreadsheet comes out and you buy that, you'll be organized for 2024, but you won't be organized for 2023. So, yeah, just you got to make a decision whether you want to use that spreadsheet for this year or you want to use it for next year. I don't think this shirt sold last night. I'm going to show it to you in a second. I don't think this shirt sold. I had an odd item in the buy it now section that didn't go. And I'm kind of surprised because this is a good price. I don't know why nobody wanted it. It's a men's medium Woolrich on a modern Woolrich tag. And this is one of those like hiking polyester shirts. It's got a zip pocket back here, a Velcro pocket, a Velcro pocket, a Velcro pocket. And it is 100%. Nylon, I think, or is it 100 poly? 100% nylon. Just a nice, like, outdoor shirt. I had this up on Whatnot for $12 in the Buy It Now section, and it lasted the whole show. Just a nice shirt. Is it super, super valuable? No, but at $12, that's a bargain. I wonder if that'll fit me, actually. It's a nice shirt. That's peak style. I was in the Buy It Now. It lasted the whole hour and 20-minute show. Go figure. You got the William and Murray's. This is going out to Ashley, and Ashley got the size 36 William and Murray's. So next week we'll have a pair of 32 William and Murray's, just a William Murray. Not William and Murray, William Murray. Really high quality golf brand. If you know, you know. Where's that hit? There's that hit right there. Someone bought pants on Posh Picks, had measurements. Posh reviewed and denied them. eBay take notes. Exactly. It's super smart. And this is the sneaky good reason why that's super smart, MV Pettit. Thanks for your order last night, by the way, MV Pettit. Really awesome. You got the Barefoot Dreams, didn't you? I shipped that one out already. You should have a shipping confirmation in your inbox. Appreciate your business. Really cool purchase on that. Softer than a rabbit's back. I think that was yours, right? But here's the sneaky good reason why that's super smart that Posh does that. Because that person can reposh that item really easily. And it uses your photos, which will include the measurements. And that person can easily put it back up on Posh and somebody will buy the item and they recoup some of their money. But here's the thing. Poshmark's going to get 20% off that sale too. So they got 20% off your sale to that customer. Now they're going to get 20% of the next one. Of course, yeah. Anyway, so for them, it's smart business. When eBay has a return and that item goes back to somebody because it didn't fit and the person ignored the measurements, eBay now refunds those fees. So they make $0.00 for that transaction. Meanwhile, Poshmark, same scenario. Poshmark makes 20% and 20%. So to say that's a $20 item, they made $8 off that. They made $8 off that. And eBay made 0.00. Crazy, right? If you think about it, really smart business move by Poshmark. That makes it easy for that person to just reposh it. If they really don't want it, reposh it, ship it out to the buyer. And Poshmark makes shipping so easy that somebody can use any of these free USPS shipping supplies. They don't have to be a master shipper on Poshmark. You all know how easy it is to ship on Poshmark. It's a brilliant move. It's a stroke of genius. And it's good for the seller, too. Someday, eBay's going to realize that if you don't take care of the sellers, you can't take care of the buyers because there's nothing for them to buy. Someday, they're going to learn that. I think they're learning it now as all these smaller companies keep taking chomps out of the market share. Chomp, chomp, chomp. Every bite hurts after a while. At first, you're like, whatever, Poshmark, they're taking some of the business. That's fine. There's enough business to go around. But then Depop comes around, and Mercari comes around, and Whatnot comes around, and Grailed comes around, and Facebook Marketplace launches on the biggest social media platform, right? All of a sudden, it's like, California, we have a problem. Yes, sir. Thanks. Nice. Damn, I missed those. What size? The Bill Murray's are 36, but I got another pair that will go next week that'll be 32s. You can use any priority box for Whatnot, right? Not the flat rates. Not the flat rates. Just normal rules. Be back soon. Jump in a Ticketmaster to try to get Morgan Wallen tickets at 11. Is that the dude that put... Oh, that's somebody different. Morgan Wallen. Who's Morgan Wallen? I don't know who that is. It sounds really familiar. Oh, it's a country singer, right? I really like, if it's who I'm thinking of, I really like Morgan Wallen, actually. It's got a few jams that they play on the radio, like super jams. So Eddie Bauer, William Murray, Robert Graham. This is a great package. Some of the best brands here. William Murray, Robert Graham, Eddie Bauer, Travex. We got a North Face jacket, too. Ashbergs with some awesome stuff. Imagine going into a store and being able to buy in the same store Robert Graham, Eddie Bauer, Travex, Bill Murray, aka William Murray, North Face, coffee, and viewer's choice number one, which is Roan shorts. I mean, imagine all those brands at the same store. That store doesn't exist. Yeah, it does. Chris at Peaks, Whatnot. Next week's going to be crazy. Okay, I need a pair of fat kid size 42. I don't have those. Sorry, brother. I appreciate it. What did I miss? I agree. So many platforms now. eBay has to up their game. Losing market share. Eventually, it hurts. I run more sales out of Whatnot every single month than eBay at this point, and it's not even close. Not even close.
now Whatnot's starting to focus on building out a marketplace. So not even just during the lives. They want it so that people can go on 24 hours a day and buy stuff from your store. I think that's going to take a while to really get some traction, but they're working on it. It's a young company and they have good technological backbone, right? Their foundation of technology is really strong because it's new technology from the ground up. It's not old, ancient stuff. So they have a leg up on eBay where they can build a search function that's probably better than eBay's. Obviously, like, the shipping's easier. The listing's easier for the seller. It's a lot of advantages. When your technology infrastructure is better and more modern, it makes it so much easier for you to try new things and execute them better. I agree. So many selling platforms. Please don't forget to delay the package. 2 days, perfect. Got you, chemo. All right. And what else do I need here? The viewer's choice number one was the Roan shorts. Where can you find Roan, Eddie Bauer, North Face, William Murray, Robert Graham, and coffee all in the same place and have it shipped to your front door with combined shipping? I need to know of this place. It sounds like heaven. Ashley, we got you a handwritten thank you card. And I'm going to put your ground fall blend. Have you tried the fall blend yet, Ashley? Shouldn't say it's a blend. It's not a blend. It's a light roast, a fall seasonal light roast. It's a single origin coffee, not a blend. The combined shipping in. Yes, exactly. So the combined shipping is automatic. I go to the shipping screen and all the items are bundled right in. I don't have to do any like adjustments or any, I don't have to click anything. It's already together because it is modern technology. Sorry, eBay. It's going to be hard to compete pretty soon. Now, I don't think that there's doom and gloom for eBay. I think they're big enough. They're going to be competitive for a while, but I think we'll continue to see their lead, so to speak, their market share. I think we'll see it evaporate. Of course, I put my tape dispenser up there. eBay, I would build a new platform that would run side by side with eBay with a new name in totally new infrastructure, like totally modern infrastructure. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then once I get that up and going, I'd probably just cut bait on eBay. But they probably don't want to give up all that, like the big sellers they have on eBay. They probably don't want to disrupt that. What if they can make a platform that makes sense for smaller sellers, build it from the ground up with all their knowledge they have about platforms? I think that'd be a smart way to go. And move a lot of their smaller customers over there at first, and then over time migrate their bigger customers over too. That's what I would do. Crap. But what do I know? Chris, just shut up and ship Ashley's order, will you? Robert Graham, coffee, Bauer, William Murray.
Roan shorts, North Face. Got it. Awesome box right there. Or they might get a good laugh out of it. I'll start contacting them. Can I start training now for when you open the UK branch? They might like to hear about the vision. There you go. I'm looking for a business operations manager. Oh, I missed something. Whatnot are looking for business operations manager, 160 to 210 plus benefits. If I contact him now, ask him to start training now for when they open the branch in UK. There you go. Or they might get a good laugh out of it. Why wouldn't they consider you? I guess they probably want somebody with like product management experience. It's probably what they'd be looking for. Morning, Lucy. They just reduced shipping to US for us Canadians. Much more reasonable prices. Nice. Who reduced the shipping? Like the Canada Post Office, or what shipping service went down? I know the answer, Chris. A P for the win. Thank you, sales. Shetty's in the house. Love the combined shipping and whatnot is growing on me, Chris. Nice, Andrew. I like to try to get $3 shirts in the middle of the night. There you go. It's fun hunting that stuff. I like hunting for steals and deals on whatnot, but you'd already know me. I get a little soured on buying a bunch because I bought a lot of stuff on whatnot, like June, July, August. I bought so much stuff on whatnot, and I got so many flawed items that were like undisclosed flaws from sellers that I just got really kind of turned off by bargain hunting on there. And it's trying to like support like little people and stuff too. And sometimes I would like bid on something and it would be like $3 and nobody else would be bidding. So I just bid again against myself to $4, to $5, to $6, because I was getting that at such a good price. And then I'd get these items and I'd be like, man, I wouldn't have spent $2 for this shirt that has like, it's all washed out and it's got stains. That wasn't all the experiences, but it's probably 10% of the experiences. And when you buy a lot, I was buying a lot. It kind of wore me down. Not interested. I just kind of don't want to do it anymore. All right, I got one more shipment. I got a Patagonia shirt. Oops. And then we got, all right, let's go ship this up. Patagonia shirt. And I got two eBay orders, two $50 sales. Nice little Patagonia seersucker piece. I think I got another Patagonia seersucker going to the show next week. $17 for this, which is just a nice low market value price on this shirt. Solid price for Max. Thank you, Max. Oh, I just wrote him two thank you cards. Put them both in there. Double thank you. Double thank you. What's your favorite way to deal with scammers? I ignore them. I ain't got time for that. I feel like there are a lot of sellers on there who don't have the same quality control as you and K-Way. Thanks, Shauna. Look, that's freaking intentional. Whatnot is a return business platform. Last night I had 11, well, I'll double check this in a second, but I think I had 11 new buyers out of 42 orders. So, you know, basically 25% were new buyers, 75% return business last night. We'll just double check that, but 75%. And the bigger orders, by the way, in terms of dollars, tend to be repeat customers. They're buying the bigger ticket items. They're buying four or five items in their box, right? So really, it was probably more like 15 or 20% of the dollars spent last night were new people. It's return business. People who have gotten a package before and were happy with it, happy with the packaging, happy with the quality, items were as described, they got a good deal. Those are the people who come back and buy week after week. Sometimes they skip some weeks. Sometimes they come once a month, whatever. People don't need to buy shirts every day, but it's a return business platform. I think all platforms are. The whole world is return business, but so that's why I'm really, really intentionally trying to get the inventory better and better and better every week, trying to deliver, making sure everyone gets a handwritten thank you note, pack really carefully. I can just stuff this stuff in a box. I ain't stupid. I understand that this takes me more time. Live shipping takes me more time, but sharing the gratitude with you is good for business. It feels right. And it's just who I am. So it's a good fit. Whatnot's a good fit for me. It's the way I like doing business anyway. I do handwritten thank you notes on all my eBay, all my Poshmark. 5 years strong, every order gets a handwritten thank you note right from the very beginning. So to me, case in point, we'll go over these numbers in just a second. And I'll share with you how important return business is on Whatnot. I got a return customer on eBay. It's a pain. It's a bummer. Got my handwritten note from Chris tacked on my corkboard. I love that. See? It's a little branding that's in your house now, too. I wish I could ship everyone a sign like that. How cool would that be? Hang it up. Megan, let me know if you have any more questions about scammers. Sorry, I just kind of answered your question briefly, but I usually just ignore them. Sometimes I have to block them, but usually just ignore. I feel like there are a lot of sellers on there. Yep. Got some South Pole shirt coming from Bold North that I'll never get my money back on. Oh, bummer. Yeah, it's good. You support the community. He's good. I buy a lot of stuff. I buy it and then I sell it and I might lose a few bucks on it, but I feel like I supported a friend. eBay Canada Post. Gotcha. So it sounds like Canada Post probably lowered their price and eBay's offering that to you. That's my take on it. I'll contact them asking if I start training now or if they can get a good laugh. I'm applying, nothing to lose. Exactly. They must be planning on expansion. They're looking for partnership associations in the UK, whatever that means. Yeah. I mean, I'm guessing that they probably don't have sellers in the UK at this point. Is that true? I'm not sure. I never got my note from Chris. It didn't brighten my day. See, that's what it's all about. If you make people feel good, that's part of this platform too. I like making money. Don't get me wrong, but if I can make somebody smile or make their day feel a little bit better, that's super valuable. There's so much negativity out there. Josh, we had the news on for like accidentally for like 10 minutes the other night. Kim finished watching the show on the couch and the news is just kind of like on after, maybe it was after football or something like that. And like after like 10 minutes of it being on, I was like, Kim, why the heck are we watching the news? This is miserable. I'm going to have a heart attack. Like my blood pressure is so high right now. There's so much negativity out there. If I can just add a little bit of positivity with a freaking thank you note like this, would ship out some orders on eBay, y'all. Ooh, I told you I was going to do something. Let's follow through. Sometimes I forget what I'm doing. So we had a total of 74 items go out the door and whatnot. 42 shipments. So 42 different people ordered on whatnot last night. Let's count how many were new customers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wait for it. Loading. 8. 8 out of 42. Just under 20%. We're talking like 82% of my orders were repeat customers. That's why I do all this stuff, because there's a lot of different ways that people could spend their money. I'd rather them spend it with me. Plus it's fun. The news is the worst. The news is a vibe killer for sure. Whew. No sound. Some news story. It's good. Okay. It's just you, sales shed. I hear you. Saw a news story that was good today. Scroll out, scroll back in. Sales said, you'll be good, Shetty. Come on, Shetty. Troubleshoot your own crap before you yell at me, sales shed. No, I'm just kidding. I appreciate you letting me know when this sounds weird. Saw a news story that was good today. 104-year-old went skydiving and broke the world record. That's crazy. 104. Skydiving. That's living right there. No whatnot sellers here yet. Only learned of whatnot from here, and I love the concept. I love the concept too. It's personal. People like that, you know? I like a personal experience. It's working. Thank you, Dwight. Dwight, we just got your order shipped out. Appreciate you, brother. I didn't know if you were working in the background or not. So there you go. 82% return customers tonight. Typically, it's about, I'll typically have around like 10, 11 new buyers out of something like 35 or 40 orders. So we'll just call it 70% of my business is return business on Whatnot, and 30% is new customers. And why is this showing that I still have one shipment to ship? Are you lying to me? Yeah, we're good. Everything shipped. Kimo, I'll wait. You still working stock. Appreciate you. Showed up as packing. Awesome, Dwight. Appreciate you. I get at least one person a month on eBay who tries to scam me into giving refunds without a return. Gosh, that's such a pain in the butt. And for me, it's just a policy. And it says it in all my listings, by the way, like, you know, to get a refund, you have to return the item in the same condition that it was sent to you. And if it was new with tags, that means unworn with the tags still attached. And once I receive the return and inspect it, I will send you a refund. That helps head people off at the pass. Not all people, but anytime somebody says, hey, I want a refund, be like, great, send the item back. I'll get that. Once I receive it, I'll inspect the item for condition to ensure that it's in the same condition as when I sent it to you. And once I do that, I will send you the refund. Thank you. Those kind of people usually go away. And I know that you probably know how to handle that backroads resale. I'm not coaching you, but you know, it's kind of more for everybody else. There is some folks, there's 40 people, 44 people between the three lives right now. So there's probably someone who's getting started right now who's like, how the heck do I handle that kind of thing? That's how I handle it. We got two eBay orders. Let's switch over. Thanks everyone for watching the Whatnot portion of the show. We're kicking over to the eBay portion of the show. The algorithm on TikTok and YouTube and Facebook is about to get messed up. So if you could do whatever you can do to tap the screen to get some engagement up, you can tap the screen on TikTok like 10 or 12 times real quick. If everyone does that, we'll get some likes up. It's telling TikTok you're having a good time. And same thing on YouTube and Facebook. If you haven't hit that like button on this particular live stream, I appreciate it. If you haven't commented yet and just said hello, say hello. Let me know where you're joining from. All that stuff helps. If you haven't followed and subscribed, I'm Chris at Peak on all platforms. YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Threads, Whatnot, chrisatpeak.com. It's all the same thing, Chris at Peak. Return request today, and I had measurements and oversized in the title. It's a pain. It's part of the biz. Unfortunately, 2.5% of my sales result in returns. Just is what it is. Thank you so much, Amanda Reeds. Appreciate all the roses. South Texas, thank you for the roses. Gifts are unnecessary. Thanks for tapping the screen. 7.3K likes. Appreciate y'all. Those likes help, especially when we're doing like context switching here. We're going from eBay to Whatnot. It really does. And the AI is like listening to us. The bots are listening, and it's like the algorithm's confused. It doesn't know how to push us out. So eBay sales, eBay sales, eBay sales. All right, we got two $50 sales on eBay. The first one is somewhere. It's this Link Sole. It's a brand you should be familiar with. It's a sort of newer one on my radar screen. It's a modern brand out of California, Link Sole. This is a brand new with tags, size extra large Stormer golf windbreaker. A lot of Link Sole stuff. It's really a golf brand at heart. So this sold on eBay for $49 plus buyers paying $8.95 shipping on this. This is going to Scott. Where are my thank you cards? Here they are. Thank you, Scott. Thank you, Scott. Lion Creek Boutique is in the house. Who's that guy? He's on Facebook. What's up, Bro Creek? You getting your shipping done this morning? Anything noteworthy to share? Scott bought a Link Sole, brand new with tags. Golf jacket. You're the golf guy. You must know Link Sole. Now let's see what this is going to. This is going out to Maryland. It's going to be cheaper if I ship it USPS regular priority. It's $735 for ground advantage. It's $720 for priority. And of course, the padded flat rate would be $830. So we're going to go regular priority on this. We're going to put it in one of these guys, actually. How much does this weigh? Starting to put more items in a box. When I can put them in a box and do it, let's see what this will weigh. Been doing more of that lately. Actually, let's see. Oh gosh, I can ship that under a pound. Let's do that. Well, how about it? Never mind the box. We're going to go under a pound and save some money. I just thought that was going to be a 2 pound rate. It's going to save me a whole 5 cents to ship it USPS priority this way. Under a pound. What is Ground Advantage? We're going to do Ground Advantage. $6.07. That's what we're going to do. Fine Creek, I got your message last night. Thank you. It's right before the show. I appreciate the positive vibes. I was right getting set up. It was perfect timing. But I didn't have time to get back to you. Thank you, Scott. Handwritten thank you for you. Happy D's here. She's watching. Use the regional boxes still. I don't really have any. I might have a couple hanging around, but they don't offer the regional rate anymore. That went sayonara. RIP regional rates. But if I have the boxes, you can still use those. Awesome. Great show. Thank you, Lion Creek. Appreciate you. Good inventory last night, eh? Thank you, Scott. That's one of our two eBay orders. $49 plus shipping on that. Next up, love me some Linksole. Great brand. Next up is this Pendleton. It is a skirt suit. So 100% wool Pendleton. You can't see the tag, but that's the blazer. And that's the matching skirt. So vintage, made in the USA, skirt suit from Pendleton. That's going to be at a 3 pound rate. Let's see where this is going. You're welcome, Chastity. Thanks for watching over on Facebook. Love the questions. Good stuff. Chastity, what kind of stuff do you resell or do you resell? I'm guessing since you're asking about regional rates, you probably know a thing or two about shipping. So what types of stuff do you like to resell? Thanks for joining. Pendleton. Ground Advantage, $9.88. Priority is $12.78. This is going to go Ground Advantage. A rare time where Ground Advantage is actually cheaper at a 3 pound rate. It's because it's going to California. Got it. UPS Ground is $9.63. I could save 25 cents by going UPS Ground, but I'm going to go Ground Advantage because they picked that up at the house. They can have the 25 cents to pick it up at my house. This is going to Tiffany. And we are going to put this, maybe we'll put this in a box. Might fit in this little box here. Let's see. A little spider in here. Little bell. It'll fit in this box. Tiffany, thanks for your order. Now putting this in this box won't add any extra cost because this item without the box weighs 2 pounds and 2 ounces. This box will probably weigh about 5 ounces. So as long as the weight doesn't go up over the next pound, which in this case would be 3 pounds, it don't matter. No difference in cost. Time for a new tape. Close, nice. Me too. I've sold all kinds of things over the years, but I like selling clothes the best. They don't break in shipping. They're easy to store. They don't take up a lot of space. And and some other things that I can't think of right now, but I like it. All right, so Spider is the perfect addition for Halloween. There you go. That would have surprised us for the buyer. Show was popping last night. Also got some awesome smell good coffee from you. Thank you. Appreciate you, Emily. Thanks for the compliment. Good morning, bro. Apple picker. Do you ever sell that bread maker? No, but I do have the, I got rid of it, but I still have the, I got to sell the parts for it. I've got to sell just the parts. Like there's two little parts on the inside. They're over there. I think they're in the garage. I got to sell those. I don't want to test the bread maker and all that crap. Okay, $9.88 USPS ground advance. I could be wrong about that. Hold on a second here. It's going to be $11.43. I had the wrong weight in. All right, $11.43.
That's going to be the cheapest option.
Noticing increase in sales on whatnot? Sometimes yes, sometimes no. It really comes down to having the better, everything sells because everything starts at a buck. But if you have better inventory, obviously the better inventory sells for more money. So last night's show was a really good show in terms of sales dollars because the inventory was really good. People made more money for nicer stuff. It's definitely a platform where there's going to be ups and downs, good weeks and bad weeks. But every week might get a few more followers over there, a few more repeat customers. 70% of my sales on Whatnot are to repeat customers. So every time I get like, if I can get some percentage of that 30% that's new every week, if I could get them come back for a following week, then you just build and build and build and build. Are you done yet? All right, eBay is done. $250 sales. I like it. $11.43 and then $6.07. That skirt suit I paid $3 for and it sold for $49 plus $12.95 shipping after shipping and fees and all that stuff. $39.23 was my profit on that piece. Pretty good. Took a little while to sell. I picked it up in March. Kind of not the right, March 28th, not the right time of year to be picking up like a wool skirt suit. But this time of year is a good time of year to be selling it. We got one more order. It's over on TikTok shop. This is going out to my friend, Karen, Cokey Pokey. She's been following me for well over 2 years. She was following me when I had like no followers. She would support me on every video I put out there. She was supporting it. Really good supporter of mine. I appreciate her so much. She's been around a long time, kind of like Nick Smith been around a long time. She put a nice little message in her TikTok shop purchase too. It says, thanks for your support these last 2 years. Taking my family of three to France with my eBay sales income. How cool is that? To be part of that community where someone feels like that I contributed to something that's that freaking cool. Family of three to France with eBay sales income. How cool is that? All right. We got an order. What did we already printed out the shipping label. What did she get? She got medium roast whole bean going out to my friend Cookie Boki. We just got one more bag of the whole bean. Don't worry, we're ordering more coffee today. It's going to get roasted tomorrow. Thanks, Cookie Boki. We'll get you shipped right out. If you're watching on TikTok, you might want to check the TikTok shop to have a really good deal. So here's what happens with TikTok shop. Free shipping on your first order for anything that's $5 or more. If you've already ordered one thing on TikTok shop, after that, each order $20 or more is free shipping, which is really cool. TikTok shop is paying for that shipping. They're eating the cost. Thank you, Cookie Boki. And you might have a coupon in there too. TikTok shop's giving out coupons, 20, 40, 50% off. You can check if you got a coupon. You definitely got free shipping. If you go to click on my name up above on TikTok, on my profile, don't click on the website. Click where it says shop, S-H-O-P, and that's TikTok shop. You can see my delicious coffee that was roasted Thursday. You can see my all my merch. The thrifting is my cardio haul bags. The thrifting is my cardio teas. And the fresh coffee is love teas. The medium roast and the light roast are both available on TikTok shop or at chris@peak.com. Get you some fresh coffee. You will not be disappointed. You'll know as soon as this shows up on your front door that this is different than that coffee that you bought at the grocery store. Coffee that you bought at the grocery store was roasted in most cases, more than 30 days ago. In most of those cases, more than 90 days ago. There's some coffee that you'll find on shelves that was literally roasted in 2022. It was coffee a year ago. I'm not really so sure if it's coffee anymore. It was barely coffee then, by the way, but that's a whole nother story. Thank you, Cookie Boki. That's going out today when the postal worker picks that stuff up. Around 2 or 3 o'clock today, you'll get a shipping confirmation. With that, I think we're all shipped out. Yep, we got. So tail of the tape is we had 42 whatnot packages, 2 eBay packages, a chris@peak.com package, and a TikTok shop package. The only thing we didn't have is Poshmark. That's 2 days in a row with no Poshmark. But Poshmark was good over the weekend. Go figure. Ups and downs of this business. Returns happened. It's okay. It's true. 2.5% of my eBay sales are returns. 0% of my Poshmark sales are returns. So that's another plus one to Poshmark. All right, y'all. I'm going to log off for the day. From here, I'm going to order more. I always do my like ordering of stuff. So I got to order coffee today. I restock my shipping supplies today. Then I don't know what I'm going to do. Maybe we'll head out and about. We got a pop walk to go to later on at Kate and Ben's. So I get to go see my goddaughter, which will be nice. And yeah, it's a beautiful day here. I don't know what I'll get into. I'll work for myself. I'll figure it out. I'll talk to the boss, see what he wants to do. Or what she wants to do more appropriately. So hoping everybody has an awesome day. Hope you find some cool stuff if you're out and about. Hope your sales keep pouring in or trickling in or whatever it is. I hope the sun's shining on you somewhere. You know what? Do something nice for somebody today. Call your mom. Text your mom. Text an old friend. Give someone a call that you've been meaning to talk to for a long time. Give an opportunity to go make somebody smile today. Why not? It won't cost you any money. And it'll make you feel good. It'll make them feel good. And maybe they'll go do something nice for somebody else. Same thing. Maybe they'll call their friend or whatever. Send a text message. It's cheap. Cheap and easy way to brighten someone's day. Let them know that you love them. All right, y'all. We'll see you tomorrow, 9:30 a.m. Eastern time. I'll be live on YouTube, on TikTok, on Facebook. Let the kindness ripple. There you go. I get them good reselling vibes listed. There you go. Have a great day, South Texas. See you later, AZ. See you, Tina. See you, Back Roads. Have a good afternoon. Thank y'all. We're done before noontime. Nice, too. Later, Andrew. Later, Big E. Later, Mother Nature Show. See you later, Chastity and Chemo. Good night, Moon. Peace.